Jeff Koons was born on January 21, 1955, making him 61 years old, in York, Pennsylvania. Koons went to the School of Art Institute of Chicago and Maryland Institute College of Art to study painting. Here, he met artist Ed Paschke, and he became a major influence for Koons, and Koons later became his studio assistant. After, he moved to New York and worked at the Museum of Modern Art while still maintaining a painting career. Jeff Koons is a very odd artist. He was one of the first artists to depend on the art market rather than art criticism. He is both hated and admired for his banal works. This is something lacking in originality and is to be obvious and boring. This comment inspired his banality series that goes from liquor and pornography to sports and entertainment. This series is to represent a taste for self-acceptance. Here are a few pieces from this series. This piece is the Pink Panther, made of glazed porcelain and made in 1988 in the Museum of Modern Art. Depicted, we see a 1960s Hollywood star, Jane Mansfield, clutching onto the limp Pink Panther. Mansfield is bare-breasted in a mint green dress, clutching the Pink Panther in one hand and the other covering her exposed breast. This, along with tilting her head back to look at the viewer, shows that she is attracting attention from the viewers. We then see the Pink Panther limp in Jane Mansfield's arms. He has a hapless weariness look as he slowly lowers his hand down her back. Not only do we see the sexuality of this piece, but also the Pink Panther is not your everyday cartoon character if he is getting it on with the gorgeous Hollywood star Jane Mansfield. This piece connects adulthood and childhood as well as innocence and sexuality. Koons states this is used to be as a female masturbation aid. So, the next time you see the Pink Panther, know he got it on with one of the biggest sex symbols of the 1960s. The next piece we see is Michael Jackson and Bubbles, made from porcelain in 1988, located in the San Francisco Museum of Modern Art. Like the Pink Panther, this is made in the Banality series. Depicted, we see Michael Jackson leaning back on a flower bed with Bubbles in his lap, wearing matching gold military style suits. This piece has multiple perspectives and is in a triangular composition. Koons used a press photo of the two as a template to make this sculpture, although he was inspired by the triangular composition of Michelangelo's Pietà. This connects the King of Pop to Christian iconography. This piece has many points of representation and symbolism. First, they are represented as one unit shown through Jackson holding Bubbles close. Next, Koons was always fascinated about Michael's self-transformation and uses this to be the symbol of human desire for self-discovery. Then, Jackson is depicted very white, glazed over, and feminine, showing how unnatural his transformation of self-exploration must be. Koons once stated, "I want to create him in a very godlike manner, but I always liked the radicality of Michael Jackson that would do absolutely anything that was necessary to be able to communicate to the people."
Many times when people speak about my works, they'll talk about how much attention is paid to the detail. The reason for that is I never want to lose the trust of the viewer. I want the viewer to be able to stay lost in the abstraction of experiencing a work for as long as possible. The Bloom Dog is part of the Celebration series. I started the series in 1994. I wanted to make a body of work that was really about archetype, to connect people to the monumental and the everyday. When I made Balloon Dog, I wanted to make a piece that reflected the joy of celebrating a birthday or a party. I bought a packet of balloons and I blew the balloons up and I just started twisting. Once I had kind of control of the medium, I chose the Balloon Dog that I felt was really, you know, the best suited to become more monumental and to blow it up in scale. Each Balloon Dog's unique. One is red, one is magenta, one is blue, one is orange, and one is yellow, to show the spectrum, and also to communicate to people that every color is perfect. I've always worked with inflatables. From the time that I was a young artist just moving to New York, I worked with inflatable flowers. I worked with vacuum cleaners, inflatable basketballs in the equilibrium tanks. More recently, balloon Venus or swan. The reason that I enjoy things that involve air is they're a symbol of us. We're breathing machines, we're inflatables. We take a deep breath, and we're a symbol of optimism, a symbol of future. If we exhale, it's a symbol of death. It's like we deflate. The balloon dog is eternally optimistic. It's in a position to stand up to time. It's materialism and it's monumentality. But also, I want to deal with the interior life of the balloon dog. And it is a little bit like a Trojan horse. When we think about a balloon, we think of its interior as being really empty. It's a void. But the balloon dog has this interior aspect in being able to parallel life's energy. It's having a dialogue with interior life and exterior life. And the balloon dog's a piece that enjoys to kind of celebrate the environments that it's placed in. We've had the environment of the Grand Canal in Venice be reflected in the balloon dog. We've had the ceilings of Versailles, the Neue National Gallery in Berlin, the Brandt Foundation, the sky and the buildings of New York City from the roof of the Metropolitan. That's what has always really attracted me to these reflective surfaces, the ability to continue the beholder's share. Art does not happen inside objects. It happens inside the viewer. Objects.